I've said this once, I'll say it again. You know you are cool when you have your own intro ahead of your segment. Ladies and gentlemen, JP Sebastian, we are talking movies, but not just any movies. We are talking about the latest movie trailers that have been released. And can I just say, when I looked at this first one that we're about to talk about, it's called Beautiful Something Left Behind. What a documentary. It hits you right in the feels, because I'm not going to steal your thunder here.
No, tell me.
But what I could literally see from this trailer is...
Snapshot sale. What was it that grabbed
you? It gives you the understanding of how a kid handles grief. And I think now that we are during a pandemic, it is so scary to wake up and see names and people putting, you know, condolences up to family members being lost. What a beautiful documentary to look forward
to. Now better than ever, I suppose. Well, you know, throughout history. I mean, even just with adults, I struggle, you know, how do you console someone? There's so much that 7 billion people don't understand about death, as whether it's a natural, biological process, spiritual, however you want to put it. But these kids are defining on their own terms how they process that grief. Documentary, as you said, Beautiful Something Left Behind, is based in New Jersey, where there's a cleverly named group called Good Grief. And kids of all races, all religions, get together and process the loss of a loved one. Both parents, even some of them, some grannies, some siblings, etc., etc. And they have these sort of group conversations that, like I said, it's structured on their own terms, but with the guidance of adult counselors and parents nearby at all times, even though they're allowed to have, there's one room, for example, called the volcano room, where they're allowed to just blow up.
Okay.
Because, you know, I feel like a baby compared to looking at these already way too wise beyond their years kids who have to deal with the kinds of things they do.
So that was quite a powerful scene with the paint, where the red and the blue represented something else and they could express their emotions in different ways.
And that sort of wisdom comes across. You don't want to sort of make too much of a deal of that. It's way too attractive to go, ooh, they're so wise beyond their years. But no kid should have to be like the way, you know, one of them's asked, don't you just want to be able to play like, inverted commas, normal kids do? But they keep this tone throughout that just seems like everyone's pushing something down, everyone's just sort of repressing something, but speak, like I said, a lot more sort of eloquently and expressively and just with more depth than even JP Sebastian does on national television. So I wish there were more things like this. I don't know if anything like this exists in South Africa, but what a beautiful idea. And like you said, especially during this pandemic, when explain to your kids what is happening and what it all means and whether there is meaning and whether you should just face the inevitability that, well, we're all going to die. And how do you make peace with that?
It? Because process, the ones left behind are the ones that have to actually process it. And I think for young minds to just give them that platform to you know, be able to express themselves and deal with these feelings, because that's going to carry into your adulthood.
And without the stricture and the structure of, this is how Zoe says you should, this is how JP says you should, trust me, I went through it when I was growing up kind of thing. It seems like they just do it very fluidly and organically.
Yeah.
So never mind just for kids, I think just for parents as well, this could be really cathartic, really therapeutic. So South Africans, maybe you want to get your hands on it. No date in SA4 just yet.
Not yet.
Might end up being on a streaming service, most likely.
Hopefully.
Yeah, but big screen, probably very little chances for the little ones. But Beautiful Something Left Behind looks absolutely heartbreaking.
So the next one, we're going to look at the trailer that was released called Stray. And what's interesting is Istanbul, I've known how many stray animals they have.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at the numbers of how many stray dogs, stray cats are in the streets of Istanbul, it is scary. And this is a documentary or film that follows one doggo in particular.
Oh, well, so there's one main doggo.
That's
Zaytan, who is a girl, by the way.
Oh!
Oh, don't worry. All dogs are good boys deep down inside, irrespective of the genders. Zaytan, Kartal, and Nazar is the other one. But did you know that it's actually a municipal policy that these dogs shall not be captured or killed? So there are 100,000 of them, and apparently they're all sort of just, you must have seen, restaurants care for them, people care for them, just
yes.
randomly.
Even when I was in Istanbul, that was the whole thing, was you just see these cats, and I mean, I'm a bit more cat obsessed, so I saw all these cats everywhere, and you want to like look after them, but that's their way of life.
You can't bring them all home, Zoe.
No,
that would be
that cat lady.
So it follows very much a similar style to, there was a documentary 2 years ago called Kedi, which followed Istanbul cats. On the other hand, so if you're a cat lady, we look out for Kedi. But Stray follows the dogs, and it really maybe it helps in a way, like sometimes you need a stranger to tell you what you're going through in life, if that makes sense. For sometimes you need to see the world through the eyes of a dog to make sense of the human drama that we're all going through. There's also probably something very special about the camera being that low at all time and giving the sense of upward grandeur and wonder to human beings. Everything has to look up at us. What are we doing? What is this crazy politics we go through, the drama of being alive? So parallel to the stray dog story, it actually has running next to it the story of Syrian refugees who are also on the street, who, well, surprise, surprise, don't have a policy that protects them on their own. So a really beautiful and humanizing and empathetic Stray, I really look forward to. But again, no date in SA just as of yet. Most likely ends up on a streaming service. I know even YouTube has Keddie on there that you can pay for. So this might end up being on YouTube, who knows? I'll tell you closer to the time that it's, you know,
when it releases.
Gets on all 4 feet.
Okay. Well, the trailer is out. I will highly encourage you to go check out Stray as well as Beautiful Something Left Behind. So go look at those trailers. That's what myself and JP just discussed. He's not going anywhere. We've got more movie trailers to bring to you right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.